koji je promijenio život. Rodio sam se u Kolumbiji, visoko u vanjskim planinama u jednom gradu, Platažera Ave.
In a Catholic family.
Katoličkoj obitelji.
I grew up with the Catholic traditions and teachings of the church.
Odrastao sam sa svim katoličkim tradicijama i učenim crkve.
When I was 14 years old, I was sent to Bogotá in Catholic Colombia.
Kad sam imao 14 godina, poslali su me u glavni grad Kolumbije, Bogotu.
And those were the 1960s.
A to su bile 60. godine 20. stoljeća.
For my generation of teenagers in the 1960s,
za moj naraštaj tineđera te 60. godine,
we faced a revolution.
Tih smo se godina suočili s jednom revolucijom.
It was all the hippies that run away from the army from the US.
Dakle, došlo je mnogo hippija koji su bježali od vojne obaveze iz Amerike.
And they brought in with them all the hallucinating drugs.
Donijeli su sa sobom sve halucinogene droge.
What they call the free or liberation of sexuality.
I donijeli su sa sobom ono kako što oni to zvali slobodu seksualnosti ili oslobođenje. Slobodu seksa.
It was the beginning of the propagation of abortion.
Istodobno, tada je počelo propagiranje pobačaja,
feminizam, homoseksual movements,
homoseksualni pokreti,
and the invasion of Eastern pagan philosophies into Western Christianity.
I naljeza istočnjačkih poganskih filozofija u zapadnom kršćanstvu.
Which was like the propagation of astrology, numerology, magic.
Zajedno sa propagiranjem astrologije, numerologije, magije.
Very soon I started to lose my Catholic faith.
Vrlo brzo sam počeo gubiti svoju katoličku vjeru.
When I was 20 years old, I got married in Bogotá and moved to Hamburg, Germany.
S 20 sam se godinu oženio u Bogoti i odselio u Hamburg, Njemačku.
In Germany, I went to school at the University of Hamburg and became an actor and a musical composer.
Studirao sam na Hamburgskom sveučilištu i postao glumac i skladatelj.
My two sons were born there.
Oni su mi rođena oba sina.
And after 7 years, I moved to Los Angeles, California.
Posle 7 godina odselio sam u Los Angeles.
I dedicated myself to work in the entertainment industry.
Osvetio sam se radu u industriji zabave.
Working as an actor, musician, composer, producer.
Radio sam kao glumac, glazbenik, skladatelj, producent.
I continue living a life away from God.
I dalje sam živio daleko od Boga.
Practicing all kinds of new age.
I prakticirao sve prakse novoga doba, new age.
And focus only on money, pleasure, fame.
Samo su ga zanimali novac, užitci, slava.
Living what they call the fast lane.
Živio sam kako to tamo zovu u traci za brzu vožnju.
In year 97, everything changed in my life.
Godine 1997, ovo se životu sve promijenilo.
I went to visit with my family during Christmas of that year.
Za Božić sam te godine otišao posjetiti svoju obitelj u Kolumbiju.
And that Christmas was a pretty sad Christmas in my family.
A to je bio vrlo prilično, dakle, tužan Božić u mojoj obitelji.
Because within the 4 years prior to that Christmas,
jer tijekom 4 godina prije toga Božića,
we have lost 5 people in the family.
Ubilo nam je 5 članova obitelji.
First, my wife died of cancer.
Prvo mi je supruga umrla od raka.
Then my younger brother died in an accident in the Bahamas.
Zatim je mlađi brat poginuo u jednom udesu na Bahamima.
Then my father died at an elderly age.
Zatim je otac umro u odmakloj dobi.
Then a brother of mine committed suicide in Bogotá.
Zatim je jedan drugi brat u Bogoti počinio samoubojstvo.
And 3 months later, my mother died.
3 mjeseca poslije toga umrla mi je mama.
So that Christmas,
pa smo toga požičali ostali četiri sestre i ja.
My sisters were practicing Catholics.
Sestre su bile praktične katolkinje.
And they didn't know how far away I was from God.
I nisu znali koliko sam ja bio daleko od Boga.
I had lived most of my life away from Colombia.
Veći dio svog života živio sam daleko od Kolumbije.
And the only one that knew was my mother, but she had been there for a year.
Jedina osoba koja to znala bila moja majka, ali ona je već godinu dana bila pokojna.
So one of my sisters invited me to go to church to pray the Divine Infant's Christmas Novena.
Jedna me sestra pozvala da idem s njima u crku na devetnicu malome Isusu.
And when I got to the church,
ja sam došao u crku,
the priest introduced the Novena saying,
svećenik je otpočeo tu devetnicu ovim riječima.
When you pray this novena with devotion and faith, the baby Jesus will grant you a grace.
Ako ovu devetnicu budete molili sa vjerom i predanošću, mali će vam Isus podariti milost.
So I said to myself,
pa si bio
I can get something out of this.
Pa sam ja sebi rekao, možda imam ovdje nešto iz toga izvući.
So I asked the baby Jesus to change my life.
Pa sam zamolio malog Isusa da mi promijeni život.
But the change of life I wanted from him was just a materialistic change.
Ali ja sam zapravo ovdje tražio promjene u materijalnom smislu.
But the baby Jesus did change my life that Christmas.
A mali Isus toga Božića doista promijenio moj život.
Only that he did change it his way.
Ali na svoj način.
The novena begins on the 16th of December and ends on the 24th of midnight mass.
Ta devetnica počinje 16. prosinca i završava 24. polnoćkom.
The 25th of December, Christmas Day, I spent it marking away.
Sam dan Božića, 25. prosinca, cijeli sam dan proveo tu lumajući.
And at midnight, I went to sleep at a coffee ranch plantation of one of my uncles.
U ponoć sam krenuo spavati na plantaži kave jednog svog ujaka.
As I was driving through the gate of the ranch,
dok sam automobilom ulazio kroz glavni ulaz na taj ranch,
six guys jumped out of the woods with machine guns and keep laughing.
Iz Brna je izletelo šest muškaraca sa strojnicama i kidnapiralo me.
They tied my hands in the back with a hood over my head.
Svezali su mi ruke na leđima, stavili mi kuljač u moju glavu.
And took me prisoner to the jungle.
I odveli me u prašinu.
They put me away in the cave.
Ugurali su me u jednu špilju.
The cave was filled with bats and all kinds of bugs.
Koja je bila puna šišniša i kukaca svih vrsta.
They kidnapped me for a ransom.
Kidnapirali su me kako bi dobili otkupninu.
Altogether I was kidnapped for 6 months.
Ukupno sam bio u tom zatočeništvu 6 mjeseci.
For the first 15 days I spent in that cave.
Ali sam prvih 15 dana bio u toj špilji.
They told me they were waiting for another group of guerrillas.
Rekli su mi da čekaju jednu drugu skupinu gerilaca.
They were supposed to be in charge of interconnecting with people in the jungle when nobody could find me.
Koja je bila zadužena odvesti me dublje u prašumu gdje me nitko ne može naći.
They would feed me once a day.
Jednom su mi dnevno davali hrane.
I was getting weaker and more desperate every day.
Svakoga sam dana bivao sve slabiji i sve očajniji.
On the day 15, those guerrillas arrived.
15. dana stigla je ona druga grupa guerrillaca.
And they told me I had to give them a very large sum of money.
I rekli mi da im moram dati vrlo velik iznos novca.
That if I didn't pay, they would kill my sister.
I ako im ne dam taj novac, da će mi to ubiti sestre.
They also told me that I had been sentenced to death.
Također su mi rekli da su i mene osudili na smrt.
That as soon as I paid the ransom, they would want to kill me.
I da će me ubiti čim je isplatiti taj novac.
So they tied me up again, put the hood back on my head and throw me back in the
će me sutra da premjestiti na drugu ulicu.
So that night was the night when I had the encounter with God that absolutely changed my life forever.
I upravo sam to te noći imao susret s Gospodinom koji je zauvijek promijenio moj život.
At first, I found myself with my life completely destroyed.
Prvo sam se zapravo osjećao kao čovjek potpuno uništen život.
I had no hope of making it out alive.
Nisam imao nikakve nade da ću ostati živ.
All of my family were in danger of getting killed.
Sva mi je obitelj bila u smrtnoj opasnosti.
The guerrillas were going to steal everything I had.
Guerrilci će mi oteti sve što imam.
My life was turned to pieces.
Život mi, cijeli mi je život bio razoren.
And all of a sudden, I enter into what we can call an ecstasy.
Na jednom sam ušao u nekakvo stanje koje možemo nazvati ekstazom.
I knew I was in the cave.
Znao sam da sam u toj štiri.
But somehow I was removed from that reality of the cave.
Ali sam nekako bio izvješten iz stvarnosti te štiri.
And I began to relive my life from my infancy on.
I počeo sam ponovno proživljavati cijeli svoj život od ranog djetinjstva nadalje.
I found myself at age 3 in the inside patio of the house where I was born in my hometown.
A vidio sam sebe kao dječaka od 3 godine u unutarnjem dvorištu moje rodne kuće.
I was on a tricycle with a stick in my hand, going through the patio, eating the plants and the flowers.
Vozao sam se na triciklu sa štapom u ruci i tim štapom udarao po cvijeću i zelenju.
I could hear the voice of a lady telling me not to do it.
Čuo sam kako mi jedna sluškinja govori da to ne čini.
I continued doing it and I continued reliving my life day by day.
Ali ja sam to nastavio učiniti i tako sam nastavio doživljavati sljedeće malo pomalo sve scene iz svoga života.
At first I thought I was dying.
Prvo sam pomislio da umrem.
Because when my mother died, I was with her.
Jer kad mi je majka umirala, bio sam s njom.
And for a few hours before she died, she spoke at length about her life.
Nekoliko sati prije smrti, dugo govorila, opširno govorila o svom životu.
But I was 47 years old at night.
Te sam noći imao 47 godina.
And I continued going through my whole life.
I stalno nastavio sam proživljavati svoj život.
When I began going through my teens,
kada sam došao do prvih tineđerskih godina,
something very difficult began to happen.
Počelo se događati nešto vrlo teško.
All of the 33 years I have lived in mortal sin,
sve one 33 godine dok sam živio u smrtnom grijehu,
my conscience had been asleep.
Moja savjest spala.
I didn't have any sense of sin at all.
Nisam imao nikakav pojam grijeha.
But all of a sudden, my conscience began to wake up.
A kada se najednom moja savjest počela buditi.
And I began to feel the most excruciating pain of my sins.
Ja sam počeo osjećati neopisivu bol svojih grijeha.
And the more I was reliving my life,
što sam dalje proživljavao svoj život,
the more complicated and deeper the pain was.
Taj bol postaje sve kompliciranija i sve dublja.
The next thing that happened,
sljedeće, što se dogodilo?
I found myself face down against the grass in what ended up being a pretty high mountain.
Našao sam se kako ležim u potrbušnoj kutrali na vrhu jedne prilično visoke planine.
I was in the midst of the most amazing silence.
Oko mene je vladala neopisivo prenikla tišina.
A silence that I could only call it a perfect silence.
Mogao bih je nazvati samo savršenom tišinom.
I could feel the whole universe.
Osjećao sam cijeli svemir.
And when I looked ahead of me in the
pogledao sam naprijed i u daljini vidio jednu drugu planinu, još višu.
The top of the mountain was covered with fog.
Vrh joj bio prekriven maglom.
And the fog began to fade away.
Ta se maglom počela razmicati.
And the most extraordinary city of light appeared on top of the mountain.
I na vrhu Petrovine pojavio se neopisivo lijep grad svjetlosti.
Even though it was so far away from me,
iako je bio jako daleko od mene,
I could perfectly see it.
Savršeno sam ga vidio.
No words could ever describe the wonder that I saw in that city.
Nema riječi kojima je moguće opisati čudesa koja sam vidio u tome gradu.
Something happened in me.
Nešto se tada u meni dogodilo.
And my soul knew that I had to have been there in that city and didn't make it.
I moja duša shvatila da sam trebao dospjeti u taj grad, u onaj grad, ali nisam u tome uspio.
So I tried to see if I could cross over to that mountain.
Pa sam pokušao vidjeti mogu li nekako prijeći na ovu drugu planinu.
But the two mountains were not connected.
Ali te dvije planine nisu bile povezane.
So my heart was troubled.
Srce mi je bilo mukano.
And I began to hear a voice that was coming from everywhere.
Tada sam značio glas koji je dolazio od svuda.
The most magnificent, merciful, and loving voice.
Neopisivo veličanstven, milosrdan glas pun ljubavi.
Even though I have been in mortal sin for 33 years,
iako sam 33 godine živio u smrtnom grijehu,
I have worshipped so many false gods.
I klanjao se mnogim lažnim bogovima.
The moment I heard that voice,
čim sam začeo taj glas,
it was God's voice.
Znao sam da je to Božji glas.
And since I knew the state of mortal sin I was in,
a budući da sam znao kako mi je stanje tada bila duša,
I felt myself with the most amazing shame.
Osjetio sam dubok, dubok sram.
But the Lord held me there.
Ali me Isus pridržao.
He didn't let me sink in my shame.
Nije mi dopuštao da se da utonem u taj sram.
And he spoke to me at length.
I dugo mi je govorio.
Some of the things I can share with you in this short time.
U ovom kratkom vremenu mogu vam reći nešto što mi, od onoga što mi je on rekao.
Is what he began telling me.
Dakle, počeo mi je govoriti.
He said he was going to show me when I began to walk away from him.
Tako što mi je rekao da će mi pokazati trenutak kada sam se počeo odrenati da je od njega.
So he placed me at age 15 in Bogota in front of a church.
Stavio me, dakle, našao sam se u dobi od 15 godina ispred jedne crkve u Bogoti.
I have been in Bogota for 3 months.
Tada sam u Bogoti bio već 3 mjeseca.
During the time I lived in my hometown,
dok sam živio u svom rodnom gradu,
I used to go to confession once a month.
Išao sam na ispovjed jednom mjesečno.
But I have been 3 months in Bogota and not going to confession.
A tada sam već u Bogoti bio 3 mjeseca i nisam se ispovjedao.
I was already beginning to lose my faith.
Već sam počeo gubiti svoju vjeru.
So he showed me how I was looking into the church to a line of people that were waiting for confession.
Pokazao mi je mene kako gledam kroz vrata i vidim jedan red ljudi koji čekaju na ispovjed.
And my first impulse was to go in and confess.
A prvi mi je poticaj bio da uđem i da se ispovijedim.
But something happened in me.
Ali se u meni nešto dogodilo.
And I turned down and walked away.
Da, pa sam tu odbio i odišao.
So the Lord showed me how painful that moment was.
Isus mi je pokazao koliko je taj trenutak bio bolan.
Because Satan took me for 33 years with him.
Jer me tada Satana uzeo pred svoje i držao me 33 godine.
When I lost my sacrament of confession,
kada sam izgubio sakrament ispovjedi,
I lost the gift of forgiveness.
Izgubio sam i dar oprosta.
And the gift of the church, which was God Himself.
I dar crkve, a crkva je Bog sam.
So He spoke to me about the Catholic Church.
Isus mi je govorio o katoličkoj crkvi.
And He told me very firmly.
I vrlo mi je opišito rekao.
The Catholic Church is my church.
Katolička crkva je moja crkva.
The only church.
Jedina crkva.
And then He showed me all the way to Abraham.
A onda mi je pokazalo sve do Abrahama.
And explained to me how the Jewish people for so many centuries.
I objasnio mi kako je židovski narod tijekom mnogih stoljeća.
Have endured so many battles and sacrifices.
Izdržavao mnoge bitke i mnoge žrtve.
To prepare the incarnation of Jesus.
Kako bi pripravio Isusovo utjelovljenje.
So He said they are our elderly brothers.
Rekao je da su oni naša starija braća.
We are a Judeo-Christian church.
Da smo mi Judeo-Kršćanska crkva.
And we are Catholics today.
I da smo mi Katolici danas.
Obviously for the grace of God.
Očito, zahvaljujući Božjoj milosti.
But for the sacrifice of the Jewish people.
Ali i žrtvi židovskog naroda.
So He said we are the new people of the new covenant of God.
Rekao je da smo mi novi narod, novog saveza Boga, novog Božjeg saveza.
Eucharistic instrument of reparation.
Da smo mi eukaristijsko sredstvo pokajanja.
And He said we are responsible for the salvation of all of humanity.
I da smo odgovorni za spasenje cijelog čovječanstva.
As much as the Jewish people were a small people.
Koliko god su židovski narod bio mali narod.
And prepared the greatest gift of humanity, which was the Messiah.
A pripremio je taj golem dar čovječanstvu, a to je dolazak Mesije.
We are taking that gift even further.
Mi taj dar nosimo još dalje.
Because through the Eucharist,
jer po Eucharistiji,
we prepare the second coming of Jesus.
Mi pripremamo drugi Isusov dolazak.
So He took me back to the sacrament of confession.
Onda me vratio natrag na sakrament ispovjedi.
And He said to me, one of the first things that Jesus did when He resurrected. One of the first things that Jesus
did. Rekao mi je jedna od prvih stvari koje je učinio kada je uskrsnuo.
Was to appear to the apostles that were praying behind closed doors. Closed doors.
Je to da se ukazao apostolima koji su molili u zatvorenoj prostoriji.
And told them that He was giving them the power to forgive sins or to retain them.
I da rekao mi je da im daje moć da odrešio grijehe ili da zadržavaju grijehe.
He instituted the sacrament of confession at that very moment.
To je trenutka ustanovio sacrament ispovjedi.
Through the apostles.
Po apostolima.
Meaning to us through the priest.
A to danas nama znači po svećenicima.
So He said, Satan is the throne of pride.
Rekao je Sotona je prijestolje pokolnosti.
And the sacrament of confession is the throne of humility and mercy.
A sakrament ispovjedi je prijestolje poniznosti i milosrđa.
There is nothing that Satan hates more than a repentant sinner.
Sotona najviše na svijetu mrzi griješnika koji se kaje.
When we kneel and confess our sins to another sinner, that is the priest.
Kada kleknemo i svoje grijehe ispovjedimo, dakle i od jednom drugom griješniku, to je svećeniku, čovjeku.
And the priest raises the hand and in the name of the church gives us the absolution.
I kada svećenik podigne ruku i date nam odrešenje u ime crkve,
there is so much power in the hand of the priest. There is so much power.
to je posvećeni kruvoj ruci, ima mnogo, mnogo moći.
That all demons flee.
Ona je toliko moćna da svi demoni bježe.
They have to obey the church.
Oni moraju slušati se.
So the sacrament of confession is like a deliverance.
Taj sakrament ispovjedi je kao oslobođenje, izbavljenje.
If you could see just a little doubt of what the Lord showed me about the sacrament of confession.
Kad biste vidjeli samo tu malu točkicu od onoga što mi je Isus pokazao o sakramentu ispovjedi,
you will confess very often.
Ispovjedali biste se vrlo često.
And you never have to worry about the state of the priest.
I nikada ne trebate se brinuti o stanju u kojem se nalazi svećenik.
Because the priest is another human being.
Jer svećenik je također ljudsko biće.
But he is anointed to have the power to forgive our sins.
Ali on je pomazan i o toj pomazni ima moć odrješivati grijehe.
So the Lord showed me the greatest gift of all.
Isus mi je pokazao zatim najveći od svih darova.
The gift of the Eucharist.
Dar Eucharistije.
He said every second of the day.
Rekao je da se svake sekunde, cijeloga dana, cijelih 24 sata.
There is a host going up in consecration.
Neko na svijetu podiže hostija na posvećenje.
The Eucharist sustains the whole world against the devil.
Eucharistija održava cijeli svijet. Znamika od demona.
There is nothing more powerful in this world.
Nema ništa snažnije na ovom svijetu.
Than a faithful Catholic.
Od vjernog katolika.
An obedient Catholic.
Od poslušnog katolika.
Because of the Eucharist.
Zahvaljujući Eucharistiji.
When you come and take communion here during the Mass.
Kada tijekom svete mise dođete ovdje na pričest.
And you walk out of the church.
I potom iziđete iz crkve.
You are turned into a torch of light.
Postavi se jedna bakra svjetla.
And wherever you go, demons flee.
I kamo god odlazite demoni, kamo god idete demoni bježe.
Because they live in the world of darkness.
Jer oni žive u svijetu mraka.
And they can't stand the light.
I ne mogu podnijeti svjetlo.
So the more light we produce as Catholics,
dakle, što više svijetla nosimo sa sobom kao katolici,
the less demons around.
To je manje demona u našoj blizini.
When the Mass is being celebrated,
za vrijeme dok se slavi misa,
all celestial court lands on the altar.
Cijeli se nebeski dvor spušta na ovaj.
And the light that lands around this area here,
i svjetlo koje osvjetljuje ovaj okoliš oko crkve,
it's so gigantic,
toliko je voljeno,
that whatever the demons were doing in this area,
da što god su demoni radili na ovome području,
they have to let it go and escape.
Moraju to od toga trenutka ostaviti i potići.
So every mass stops the work of Satan in many ways.
Dakle, svaka sveta misa zaustavlja djelovanje Sotone na mnogo načina.
And every one of us that is faithful and obedient,
i svako od nas koji je poslušan i u vjeri,
stop the work of Satan in many ways also.
Također zaustavlja djelovanje Sotone na mnogo načina.
A lot of people are concerned about their loved ones. A lot of people are concerned about their loved ones.
A mnogi se ljudi brinu za svoje voljene, za svoje bližnje, članove obitelji.
And they wonder what they have to do for the conversion of their children or their friends.
I jako su u prizi što bi oni mogli napraviti da bi im se prijatelji i djeca obratili.
We know that words many times don't make it.
Znamo da često riječi u tome ne pomažu.
But there is one thing that makes it.
Ali postoje nešto što pomaže.
Our holiness.
Naša svetost.
Our obedience to God.
Naša poslušnost Bogu.
Because if we are truly holy and obedient.
Jer ako smo istinski sveti i poslušni.
We have so much light.
Nosimo i imamo toliko svjetla.
That we will end up chopping the chains your family is chained up to.
Da ćemo završiti tako što ćemo raskinuti lance kojima su svezani članovi vaše obitelji.
But watch it.
Ali pripazite.
Religion alone or religiosity is not enough.
Religioznost nije dovoljna. Dovoljna.
A lot of people prays a lot. A lot of people pray a lot.
Mnogo ljudi mnogo mole.
But if we do not change the heart,
ali ako ne promijenimo svoje srce,
then our heart is not clean.
I ako nam srce nije čisto,
our prayers are worthless.
Naše molitve manje vrijedne.
You can spend the whole day on your knees.
Možete cijeli dan prečati.
But if your heart is not 100% with God,
ali ako vam srce nije 100% s Bogom,
your religion is not doing anything.
Vaša religioznost ne postiže ništa.
But if you are faithful and your heart is clean,
ali ako ste vjerni i ako je srce čisto,
you are a tower of light.
Vi ste živući toren svjetla.
You have the power to destroy giants of hell.
Tada imate snagu uništiti divove patnje.
There is no such a thing as an insignificant Catholic life.
Ne postoji nešto što bismo mogli nazvati beznačajnim katoličkim životom.
Every single Catholic is a giant in the spiritual world.
Svaki pojedini katolik je bio u duhovnom svijetu.
So you wonder what your mission is in this life?
Dakle, možda se pitate što je vaše poslanje u ovom životu.
I can tell you what the Lord told me.
Ne mogu vam reći ono što mi je Isus rekao.
Our mission as Catholics in this life?
Naše poslanje kao katolika u ovom životu?
Is to be perfectly obedient and holy.
Jest biti savršeno poslušni i sveti.
God will do the rest.
Bog će učiniti ostalo.
So don't look anywhere else.
Nemojte tražiti ništa drugo.
The Lord placed me in a lake with the water up to my waist.
Zatim me Isus stavio u jedno jezero, voda mi je bila do pojasa.
In front of the lake there was a big rock.
Pokraj jezera bila jedna velika stijena.
And on top of the rock I could see the head of a man looking sideways.
Na vrhu te stijene vidio sam glavu jednog muškarca kako gleda u stranu.
At first I didn't know who he was.
Prvo nisam znao tko je to.
So I looked down to the water and I could see there was something like fog.
Pogledao sam vodu i vidio nekakvu maglu.
But when I looked closer to the fog I noticed it wasn't fog. It was a spirit of evil.
Kad sam malo bolje pogledao, vidio sam da to nije mogla, da to nije magla, nego da su to duhovi zla.
There were many, many of them.
Bilo ih je mnoštvo.
They were the spirits of my mortal sins of 33 years.
Bili su to duhovi mojih smrtnih grijeha iz onih 33 godine.
And the most mysterious part,
i najveća tajna,
is that my soul knew each one of them.
I to da je moja duša poznavala svakog toga zlog duha.
And when I looked at one of them,
kad sam pogledao jednoga,
I could see the sin alive.
Vidio sam u tom trenutku živi taj moj grijeh.
And I will never be able to describe to you how horrible and painful that was.
Nikakvim riječima ne bi mogao opisati koliko je to bilo strahotno i bolno.
I was trapped in that water.
Bio sam kao u kvorci u toj vodi.
In the midst of my sins.
Usred svoje grijeha.
I belong to all those spirits.
Ja sam njima pripadao svim tim duhovima.
My mortal thought things were persons.
Moji smrtni grijesi bili su osobe.
And I was a slave to them.
A ja sam bio njihov rob.
So I looked up to the rock.
Zatim sam pogledao obetovnu stijenu.
And I realized that that man that was on top of the rock.
I shvatio da je onaj čovjek na vrhu stijeni.
Was my guardian angel.
Moj anđel čuva.
And he was the one showing me all of this in the lake.
I da mi on pokazuje sve to u jezeru.
He showed me how the devil was leading me into hell.
Pokazivao mi je kako me đavao uvodio u pakao.
If the Lord would have rescued me that night,
da me Isus te noći nije izbavio,
I would have been condemned.
Bio bih vječno osuđen.
On the left side of the lake,
s lijeve strane tog jezera,
I could see that it was going down into an abyss.
Vidio sam da se gledalo spuštano u nekakav ponor.
And thousands and thousands of spirits of evil.
I tisuće duhova zla.
It was very complicated and impossible to explain.
Vrlo komplicirano obliku, vrlo nemoguće objasniti.
The most little sins of my life that was leading me straight to hell.
Dakle, bili su to smrtni grijesi iz moga života koji su me vodili u taj pakao.
Where my sins of impurity, sexual impurity.
I najsmrtonosniji grijesovi bili su, grije moji grijesi bili su oni koji su se ticali moje seksualnosti, nečistoće u spolnom životu.
If you could see just a dot of a demon of impurity,
kada biste vidjeli samo jednu točkicu jednog demona nečistoće,
you will never see.
Nikada ne biste počeli grijeh.
They are the most horrifying demons you can ever imagine to see.
To su najstrahotniji demoni na koje možete znati.
And there were a chain of sins that were leading me down to the abyss.
I oni su bili kao lanac grijeha koji me vodio u pekao.
Among them, materialism.
Među njima je bio i materialism.
The love and attachments to material things.
Ljubav prema materialnim stvarima i navezanost na materialne stvari.
Lying.
Laž.
Lying is such an incredibly terrifying sin.
Laganje je strašno, strašno grijeh.
Because it produces a lot of damage.
Jer bi stvara golemu štetu.
And it is an immense offense to God.
I golema je uvreda Bogu.
And so were all the capital sins. They were all the living spirits of condemnation.
A jednako je i sa svim smrtnim grijesima. Svi su oni bili duhovi koji vode u vječno profetstvo.
On the right side of the lake,
s desne strane jezera,
I could see many, many souls.
Vidio sam mnoštvo, mnoštvo duša.
And they were in uncountable levels.
I one su se nalazile na nebrojenom mnoštvu raznih razina, raznih nivoa.
And they were going up into the light.
I sve su se penjale prema svijetu.
But I could see that it was a very complicated way of going up to the light.
A vidio sam da je njihovo uspinjanje prema svijetu vrlo, vrlo komplicirano.
All of them were already gone from the earthly life.
A da su sve su to bile duše koje su otišli iz ovog zemaljskog života.
But they were still resolving their earthly life.
Ali su još uvijek u tome stanju razrešavali svoje ovozemaljski život.
In many different areas of their earthly life.
Razrešavali su dakle mnoga različita područja svoga ovozemaljskog života.
And that is purgatory.
I to je bilo čistilište.
It is the most incredible sample of the mercy of God.
Dakle, čistilište je nevjerojatni dar na Božih milosrća.
You know, when a person dies,
Kada osoba umre,
it has no chance to even think about dying.
Kada osoba umre, ona više nema priliku niti pomisliti da na to da umre.
Still, it takes a while for the soul to come out of the flesh of the body.
Ali potrebno je neko vrijeme da duša iziđe iz tijela.
So every soul has an illumination of consciousness before coming out of the body.
Svaka duša doživi prosvjetljenje svoje savjesti prije nego što iziđe iz tijela.
That is when the incredible compassion and mercy of God shows up.
Tada se zapravo pojavljuje nevjerojatno sućut i milosrđe Božje.
There is something that the angel taught me.
To me je poučio moj anđel.
And it was something like the economy of the soul.
I to je slično na nešto što možemo nazvati ekonomija duše.
God keeps perfect numbers of our life. God keeps perfect numbers.
Bog, kako se to kaže to? Vodi, savršeno računovodstvo naše duše.
The angels show me at age 12 in my hometown.
Taj mi anđel pokazao mene u dobi 12 godina u mom rodnom gradu.
Was the main trumpet player in my school band.
Bio sam glavni trubač u školskom sastavu.
I was on a procession and in front of me there were four guys carrying a statue of Our Lady.
Bio sam sebe kako sudjeluje u procesiji, a ispred mene su četvorica muškaraca nosila kipu naše gospe.
And I was playing the trumpet behind.
Ja sam se svirao trubu.
All of a sudden, Our Lady was no longer a statue.
Na jedno više naša gospa nije bila kipa.
She was walking in front of me, holding the child on each hand.
Nego je hodala ispred mene i svakom rukom držala po jedno dijete.
And I kept on playing the trumpet behind her.
A ja sam iza nje i dalje svirao trubu.
She kept on walking.
A ona je hodala.
And when I looked at the right hand of the child that she was carrying,
a kad sam pogledao ovo dijete koje je držala desnom rukom,
I could see it was me at age 7.
Vidio sam da sam to ja u dobi od 7 godina.
So there were two me's in that process.
Dakle, u toj procesu je bilo dva ja, dva mene, jedan od 12 godina i jedan od 7.
It's very difficult to explain.
Teško je to objasniti.
But the angels showed me how for 4 or 5 years I played the trumpet in my hometown in many different processions.
A moj mi anđelo zapravo pokazivao sve preprilike u kojima sam u rodnom gradu sudjelovao svima u procesima tijekom tih 5 godina.
And during the 33 years that I lived in mortal sin,
i ja, tijekom onih 30 godina, koliko sam živio u smrtnom grijehu,
the Lord used some of those processes to protect me from great dangers.
Isus je upotrebljavao neku od tih procesija, dakle mogu sudjelovanja u procesima, kako bi me zaštitio od velike opasnosti.
He told me exactly which process was used for which danger.
Pokazao mi je točno koju je Isus procesiju upotrebio da bi me zaštitio od koje opasnosti.
The mercy of God is so immense.
Božja milosrđe tako govorio.
One can never imagine.
Da to čovjek ne može zamisliti.
But we have to be very careful.
Ali moramo biti vrlo oprezni.
Because God is also justice.
Jer Bog je i pravda.
So do not ever take that mercy for granted.
Nemojte dati njegovu milost da uzimate zdravo za gotovo.
Because as much as God is perfectly merciful,
jer jednako kao što je Bog savršeno milosrdan,
is also perfectly just.
On je jednako tako i savršeno pravedan.
He is the only one that knows our heart.
on jedini poznaje naše srce.
He knows our true intentions.
On poznaje naše istinske namjere.
And on those intentions is what God's justice will come upon.
I upravo će Božja pravda djelovati prema tim namjerama.
So we can never fool God.
Dakle, ne možemo nikad Boga zavarati.
In that state of purgatory,
i u stanju čistilišta,
one of the sins that I saw that were more prominent,
jedan od istaknutih grijeha koje sam vidio,
were lukewarmness.
Bio je grijeh mlakosti.
The typical Catholic that is prayerful,
a to znači biti tipičan Katolik koji moli,
that helps the church,
koji daje pomoć crkvi,
that appears to be a good Catholic,
koji izgleda da je dobar Katolik,
but lives a double life,
ali vodi dvostruki život.
Because it's one person in the church,
jer je jedna osoba dok je u crkvi,
and one person in the world,
a druga osoba vani u svijetu.
It's like two people.
On je zapravo kao dvije osobe.
And there are many, many of them in purgatory.
I takvih u čistilištu ima vrlo mnogo.
And I know some of them even get condemned.
A znam da neki takvi čak bivaju vječno osuđeni.
So, there is a rock was filled with light.
Na jednom je ona stjena, jezera, bila puna svjetla.
And I knew that that light was Jesus.
I znao sam da je to svjetlo Isus.
But I knew I couldn't look at him.
Ali sam znao i da ne mogu gledati.
Because of the state of mortal sin I was in.
Zbog stanja smrtnog grijeha u kojem sam bio.
I was standing in that water in the midst of all of my mortal sins.
Stajao sam na toj vodi usred svih svojih smrtnih grijeha.
So I couldn't possibly imagine being able to look at Jesus.
I sam mogao ne zamisliti da bih imao snage pogledati Isus.
But he gave me the strength to look at the light.
Ali on mi je dao tu snagu da pogledam to svjetlo.
And when I looked at the light, I was blinded.
I kad sam ga pogledao, zaslijepio me.
But he kept me looking at the light.
Ali on me pridržavao da je dalje gledao.
And little by little, the person of Jesus began to appear in that light.
I malo pomalo od se svijetlo počela pojavljivati Isusova osoba.
But his person was all made of light.
A njegova je osoba bila sva sazrana od svijeta.
When I looked at his eyes,
kad sam mu pogledao u oči,
I could see like the most precious fire.
Bile su kao prekrasne bakre.
And through his eyes I could see endless dimensions.
I kroz njegove sam oči vidio beskrajne dimenzije.
Impossible to describe.
Ne moguće ih je opisati.
I came off the ecstasy.
Izišao sam iz ekstaze.
And I knew something really big happened to me.
I znao sam da mi se nešto doista veliko dogodilo.
I was back in the reality of the cave.
Ponovno sam našao sam se opet u toj stvarnosti špilje.
The next day the gorillas took me out of the cave.
Sutra su me gorilci izvukli iz špilje.
And I spent 5.5 months more prisoner in the jungle.
I još sam 5.5 mjeseci proveo u prašumu kao njihov zatočenik.
Every day I was begging the Lord not to let me die without confession.
Svakog sam dana preklinao Isusa da ne dopusti da umrem bez ispovjeda.
I didn't want to ever go back to that lake and find myself in the midst of all of those demons.
Nisam mogao ni zamisliti da bi mogao se ponovno naći u onom jezeru usred onih svih demona.
I knew from what the Lord taught me,
iz onoga što mi je Isus rekao, znao sam,
that if I would have been confessed,
da ako se ne bi spovjedim,
no demons would have been in the water. No demons would have been in the water. If I would have been confessed.
Znao sam da sam tada bio ispovjeđen, u toj godini ne bi bilo demona.
So I was begging the Lord not to let me die without confessing.
Pa sam preklinjao Gospodina da mi ne dopusti da umrem bez ispovjede.
One night at the
jedne su me noće kolegici odveli do jedne ceste.
And they told me to walk straight and not to look back.
I rekli mi da samo hodam i da se ne okrećem.
That was the longest walk of my life.
Bio je to najbolji od moga života.
Because I knew they were going to kill me.
Jer sam znao da će me ubiti.
And I walked for a while until I reached the curve of the road.
I tako sam hodao dok nisam došao do jedne krivine.
And I looked back to the corner of my eye.
Okrenula sam se i krajičkom oka.
And I could see they were going back into the jungle.
Vidio da se gerenci vraćaju u prašinu.
I thought I could be free, but I couldn't trust them.
Pomislio sam možda sam slobodan, ali nisam im mogao vjerovati.
So I kept on walking for a few hours.
I još sam nekoliko sati hodao.
It was very dark.
Bilo je mrtvi mrak.
And all of a sudden an old bus showed up and stopped a few meters ahead of me.
Najednog se pojavio da stavio autobus i stao nekoliko metra ispred mene.
I ran towards the bus.
Otrčao sam.
And when the door opened.
I kako se vrata otvorila.
A gorilla woman walked out of the bus and went into the jungle.
Išla je jedna gorilla i otišla u prašinu.
I began to stay in the bus.
Htio sam ući u autobus.
But the driver closed the door in my face.
Ali mi je vozač uprio vrata pred nosom.
He didn't want me in the bus because my appearance was terrible.
Nije me htio u autobusu jer sam grozno izgledao.
I had my beard down to my chest.
Imao sam buku bradu.
I looked like a skeleton.
Htio sam kosti koža.
My clothes was all ripped.
Sva mi je moguća bila podirana.
I looked like a madman that came out of the woods.
I gledao sam kao neka luđak iz prašine.
But I walked into the bus and sat in the back seat.
Ali sam se ugurao u autobus i sjao na stražnje sjedlo.
I told the driver that I was a kidnapped person that was just released.
Rekao sjednom vozaču da su me kidnapirali i ubrali u slobodnje, ali on je vjerovao.
But he kept on driving.
Nastavio voziti.
And at first I didn't know where I was.
Prvo nisam znao gdje sam.
After a long drive and going to different towns.
Nakon duge vožnje i prolaska kroz više gradova.
I began to have an idea where I was.
Počeo sam da znam gdje sam.
And when I saw a town that was close to my sister's city.
Kad sam došao u jedan grad, blizu grada u kojem su mi živjeli sestre,
I got out of the bus.
Išao sam.
And I reunited with my sister, which you probably imagine how emotional it was.
I sastao sam sa sestrama, možete zamisliti koliko to bilo emocionalno.
The first thing I did is I went to confession.
Prvo sam počeo ispovijed.
That was the longest confession of my life.
I to je bila najbolja ispovijed u mome životu.
After that, I went back to Los Angeles, California, to my home. I was madly in love with the church. I was going to church every day, and we visit different churches in Los
Angeles.
Sometimes I spent hours on my own in the church.
Ponekad sam sam, da je provodio sam od crkvi.
I didn't share my story with anybody.
Nikome nisam pričao svoj iskustvo.
And I didn't know I had a mission.
Niti sam znao da imam poslanje.
2 years later, I went back to Colombia during a holy week.
2 godine poslije toga otišao sam u Kolumbiju za veliki tjedan.
And on Sunday, I went to Mass at a big church in Bogotá.
Na svijetnicu sam odšao na svijetu misu i u veliku crkvu u Bogotu.
The church was packed.
Bila je krcata.
I didn't make it in.
Nisam uspio ući.
So I was outside the atrium looking into the main door.
Bio sam u predvorju i gledao kroz dva vrata.
All I could see from the top of the heads of people.
Iznad glava svih tih ljudi vidio sam samo
was a big crucifix that was hanging from the top of the altar. And I felt dizzy, I thought I was fainting.
Tako sam se osjećao da sam pomislio da ću upasti u nesvijest.
But what I was having was another experience with Jesus.
A zapravo sam tada doživio jedno drugo iskustvo s Isusom.
I couldn't possibly explain to you how that works.
Kako se to događa? Ne bih vam to mogao nikako objasniti.
It lasted for a while.
Trajalo neko vrijeme.
The Lord Jesus told me that what I experienced in that cave at night was infused in my heart.
Gospodin Isus mi je rekao da ono što sam one noći doživio, ono što vidite, da on to ulio u moje srce.
And that it was for me to share with everybody.
I da to moram prenositi svima.
He said, I was born for this mission.
Rekao mi je da sam se rodio za to poslanje.
That he was going to take me all around the world.
Da će me ono povesti po cijelom svijetu.
That every place I was going to go to.
Da svako mjesto u koje ću doći.
He had already chosen.
Je on već odabrao.
And every person that was going to listen to me.
I da je svaku osobu koja će me slušati.
He had already chosen by name.
On već odabrao po imenu.
He told me that he was going to take care of me.
Rekao mi je da će se on brinuti o meni.
My two sons were grown up and independent already.
Tada su mi oba sina bila odrasla, neovisna.
My wife had died 5 years before my kidnapping.
Supruga mi je umrla 5 godina prije nego su mi bili.
The guerrillas had stolen everything I had.
Gerilice su mi odbili sve što sam imao.
So the Lord had a perfect plan in my life.
Dakle, Isus je imao savršen plan za moj život.
So I walked away from my artistic career.
Napustio sam svoju umjetničku karijeru.
And founded a mission with the Archdiocese of Bogota called the Pilgrims of Love.
I osnovao misiju s biskupijom Bogota koja se zove Hodočasnici ljubavi.
I have been traveling the world for 18 years.
Putujem svijetom već 18 godina.
Through the 5 continents.
Preko 5 kontinenta.
So far we counted 114 countries visited.
Do sad smo nabrojili da sam bio u 114 zemalja.
And this is what I do every day of my life.
I upravo ovo danas, svaka dana moga života.
To end, I can tell you.
Za kraj mogu reći
da je came tonight,
da je razlog u kojoj sam došao večeras.
It's not because I want to make a spectacle of myself.
Nije to da bih od sebe dao spektakl.
I came tonight because I really care about your salvation.
Došao sam večeras ovamo zato što mi je doista stalo do vašeg.
I don't want any of you to find yourself the way I found myself before Jesus.
Nikako ne bih volio da se itko od vas nađe u ovoj situaciji kako se ja našao kad sam se susreo s Isusom.
This life is an instant.
Ovaj život je kao trenutak.
And it's going to be over very soon.
Je vrlo će brzo proći.
We have to be prepared.
Moramo biti pripravni.
Because life doesn't end in the tomb.
Jer život ne završava u grobu.
We are to be ready.
Moramo biti spremni.
Don't let yourself be seduced by this material world.
Ne dopustite da vas zavede ovaj materijalni svijet.
The only way to live this life as Catholics.
Jedini način na koji trebamo živjeti ovaj život kao katolici
is by being obedient and following.
Je stvar da budemo poslušni sveti.
There is no other way.
Nema drugog načina.
And you will never regret it.
I nikada nećete to pokazati.
If you could only see a little bit,
kada biste vidjeli samo mali dijelić
of what the Lord showed me or what He's prepared for us.
Ono što mi je Isus pokazao i ono što je On za nas pripravio.
If we obey Him.
Ako smo mu poslušni.
We will spend the rest of our lives in our knees.
Cijeli bismo do krvu, do krvne života koje je treća od njih.
Amen.
Amen.